Today we're taking a look at the CCX suppressor from JK Armament. Let's get right into the first 30 second breakdown. That's right, in the first 30 seconds, give or take, I give you guys my exact thoughts on this product before we get into the full review. That way you can just stop watching because now you know exactly why I think about this product, or you can stick around, find out why I say those things in further detail, and it does help out with the YouTube algorithm. So the first thing most people notice about this is how different it is, and one of the coolest and most notable things about this is it is mission configurable. And what that means is you can go from this size all the way to this size and anywhere in between depending what you are doing with the firearm. So whether you want the most sound suppression as possible and you are dedicating this to a handgun, or you are looking for a concealed carry setup as the small as possible and you still want that sound suppression, you can really change it up depending what you're doing. This has tone technology, which they have one of these baffles that you can rotate in different positions and you can change the tone of the suppressor, and it has more of a bass tone opposed to that high tone. You can run this dry or wet. You do not have to have suppressor tight sights with this because of how low it is, which is a cool little benefit. And you do not have to add a booster, so less things to go wrong. Not a lot of people know this, but you can switch the end cap to a 22 long rifle end cap and you can make this a 22 suppressor, which is really cool because for the price of $400, you get a 9mm and a 22 suppressor. It's not as quiet as a dedicated 22, but you don't have to buy two of them, have two tax stamps, wait two times. You can do both with one can. They have excellent warranty with these. Basically, no questions asked. So think of like your Vortex warranties, the gold standard of warranties, which is always good to see that a company backs its product. And it comes from a team of guys that have been in and around the suppressor world for decades. So they know what they're talking about and what they're doing when making suppressors. So that is really cool. Let's get into my relationship with JK Armament. They did send me this suppressor. I did not spend my own money on it. And they also sent me the RCX suppressor that you've probably seen on my CZ600 range, my 6.5 Creedmoor, my 300 Blackout, a couple other ones that I've been rotating on, really testing the suppressor along with the guns and how they are as a host. But I met these guys out at NRA show and they're a great group of guys. So now let's get into the full review. Later in the video, I actually have a test where we test this suppressor from its full length all the way down to its smallest length and do a sound test. Basically, is it hearing safe from this baffle? And then we remove one baffle at a time all the way to the smallest length and be able to tell you guys if it is quiet enough to be able to shoot and be comfortable and hearing safe. So I'm going back down to the smaller size because I think this is so cool that you can have something this small. It's like the size of a key fob, which is what they've compared it to on their social media. Kind of the size of the head of this flashlight almost. If they were side by side, they'd be very comparable in size, which is pretty impressive. But it's still able to suppress that sound and make this not blow your ears out. So this was designed for a home defense concealed carry setup. This is not designed to go out and burn down 300 rounds on full auto. This is more purpose driven, and that is where the mission configurable comes in as well, to where you can rotate these baffles and make this as long as you want it depending what you're doing. I carry it in this configuration the majority of the time because I carry this in like my tactical fanny pack. Sounds cooler if you say tactical in front of it, but basically it's a fanny pack, a Vertex fanny pack. It's pretty cool, but I carry that a lot. But I carry it in that, and this is able to fit in there very nicely. I'm able to have sound suppression. I'm not gonna blow my ears out if I happen to shoot this in this room and make me and my family deaf, which is a really cool benefit, and it doesn't add a ton to your gun. Now, if you're like, okay, I'm gonna keep this in my nightstand and I want it to be as sound suppressive as possible, you just add the baffles to whatever length you want, and then it is gonna continue to be more sound suppressive, which is really cool because it basically allows the user to decide what they wanna do with it. And that's where that mission configurable comes. So I'm probably gonna mention this quite a bit in this review, and this is a long review because I add a full test on the end of it. So be patient with me, but I've got a lot to say about this because there's a lot to mention about the suppressor and JK Armament as a company. So one cool thing is it has tone technology is what they call it. One of these baffles is designed a little bit differently, and if you move that baffle around in different configurations, you can change the tone. So basically you can kind of make it more of a preference to your ear. Like, okay, I don't like the tone with this one. Let's move it down here and shoot it and test it. And be, okay, I like that better. I think it's quieter. It might not be quieter versus louder, but it's more of a tone. Like, okay, that has a deeper tone and I like that. So you can really customize this suppressor a lot compared to most suppressors, basically any suppressor. I don't know what really any suppressors that have all these options. Most suppressors are like, okay, yeah, it shoots and it's quiet and this is what you get. This one has a lot of cool options. And going along with that tone, JK Armament chose more of a bass tone opposed to that high tone. Some of the suppressors you shoot have a little bit higher pitch. These ones are more of that bass. So it's gonna, again, come down to a personal preference. So they recommend that you run this wet. And for those of you that don't know what that means, you would put Vaseline or some kind of lubricant into the suppressor. So that helps with two different things. One of them being the most important is that it makes it quieter actually using a lubricant. It's pretty cool when you shoot this with or without the lubricant, there is an audible tone difference. So you don't have to if you don't want to, you can run this dry, but they do recommend running it lubricated, and I agree, I would do that too. So I would run it wet because it does make it quieter and it's pretty cool. What that else that does is it actually makes it really easy to clean and take apart. So it helps allow these to open and close easier when you're rotating lengths and taking out the baffles. And when you go to clean it, you can wipe it out a lot easier because you have lubricant inside of it. I'll go over this a little bit more detail during the testing because I actually show you guys how I lubricate it and everything, and I do that during the testing for this audible shooting. And this again is not meant for going out to the range and burning it down. So you might be like, okay, that's really annoying. Why would I want to throw lubricant in my suppressor every time I shoot it? Really where this is designed, it should be a more of I'm going to lubricate this, put this on my gun, and then you're good to go. You shouldn't be going out and shooting 300 rounds and burning it down. You're basically going to put your lubricant on here and you're going to carry this gun and you're good. It's not something that you're gonna have to do often. It's not like, okay, I'm gonna have to do this every day I go to the range, because this is a concealed carry home defense setup is what you're gonna primarily be using this for. Now you might be saying, like, why in the world would I want a suppressor that I don't want to shoot 300 rounds? They do have suppressors on their website that could do that. They have different suppressors. This is just what this one was designed for. So it's not like, okay, all their suppressors are silly because I can only shoot so many rounds through because he said you don't want to burn it down. If you want that and that's what you're looking for, this might not be the suppressor for you. This is just what this particular suppressor was designed for. Something I noticed when testing the suppressor on this host is you do not need suppressor height sights for the suppressor because of how small it is. So these are stock Glock sights, and I had no troubles using this with this gun and not having to get taller sights. So that's kind of a nice little benefit. If you run an optic, it's not going to be an issue either way. But if you don't want to switch out your sights, or you just have a gun like this that does not have suppressor height sights, you can still use those. So if you have like Treasurecon HDXRs that you really like, you can still rock those and not have to change anything or upgrade anything. So another benefit is you do not have to have a booster on this. So there's just one less thing to go wrong, because adding different parts and more accessories is always not the greatest thing. It's just like optics that are direct mounted versus using plates. I would personally rather have it direct mounted than having to use like an MOS or like a plate system like this, because it just gives you one more thing that could potentially go wrong. Is it gonna go wrong? Probably not. Still gonna probably work just fine, but it has one more possibility of something failing, and I would rather eliminate that to as little as possible. So there is none, so it's a direct thread. So now let's go over the fact that you can turn this into a 22 long rifle suppressor. I'm gonna actually get my Bergera here to show you. So now I have it on this host, and this is a 22 long rifle training rifle from Bergera, and there's gonna be a video on this rifle very soon. So this is currently being tested, but you can throw the CCX on here just by switching the end cap out. I do not currently have the 22 end cap, but that will be coming here shortly, but I'll be making some videos of me running this rifle with that end cap here soon. Trust me, I've got a ton of content planned for these suppressors. So I'm gonna be testing a couple different ones as well, but just wanted to start here with the CCX because I thought this was kind of the most unique and the most popular right now, I think, just because of that size and be able to conceal carry with it. But I think that's really cool. So for $400, you can have a 22 and a 9mm suppressor. Again, I don't want you to think this is gonna be the quietest 22 suppressor out there, because a dedicated 22 suppressor will be quieter. So now let's go over the warranty. They have a very good warranty. Think of your Vortex, a VIP warranty with a suppressor. So it's cool to see a company that thinks that highly of their product, that they're willing to basically say, hey, basically anything, just send it in and we'll make sure it's right. So that is pretty cool. And let's talk a second about the JK team. So JK Armament is a very new company, and a lot of people will be like, well, I've never heard of these guys. Where'd they come from? Are these suppressors even that good? How much do they know about suppressors? So the crew from JK has been around suppressors for decades. They used to be a part of like Gemtech. Some of them have some different backgrounds as well. I'm not gonna go too deep into that, but these guys have been in and around suppressors for a long time, and they've made some really cool stuff, which is cool, because when I met them out at NRA show, they were very knowledgeable about these things, and honestly have a really cool crew. So with all that out of the way, I apologize this being a little bit longer of a review. I was gonna break it into two videos, but I figured, you know what, I should just put it all into one video, because I think it's cool to have it all in one area so you don't have to go to another video. Make it as efficient as possible. So let's get right into the test of this, of me shooting it, and then we'll drop the baffle from there to see how hearing safe it is. Right here at the range, testing the CCX from JK Armament. The goal is to hear how it sounds at the full length, going all the way down to its smallest length. So we're gonna remove a baffle after each
each shot. So we're gonna do two shot successions, and then we'll come back, we'll throw more Vaseline in, and then we'll go out and do two more shots after we remove a baffle, and we'll go to the smallest. So there's nothing scientific about this. We're not using an actual like machine that tells you the sound. If that's something we wanna do in the future, we can. But what we wanna do is just be out here, no hearing protection, and then we're just gonna tell you what we hear just to give you an idea of what this sounds like. So we've got 147 grain, 9mm from Blazer. We're gonna be using that ammo. There is some quieter if you buy specific ammo. I feel like this is the ammo that most people are gonna use through these. So that's what we went with. But we'll run out, we'll start with this at the full length, and then we'll shoot two shots, see what happens. We'll share our thoughts, and then we'll go from there and continue all the way down to the shortest length to see if this is quite enough for concealed carry at that tiny length. So JK recommends that you run this wet versus dry. And for those of you that don't know, because I didn't know before either, wet means you have to use like a petroleum-based jelly type thing, like Vaseline. Product placement. So we're gonna use this to fill this up and make it a wet suppressor opposed to a dry, which you don't use anything. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna break down all your baffles, and then they say to do it quite heavily. So we're just gonna take a whole finger full of this. We're just gonna wipe it around and then do it on the inside. It also helps with cleaning, which is kind of nice because when you're done with this, it wipes away a lot easier. So not even just the sound suppression and what they recommend, it also helps when you are storing this for a long period of time and you want to actually break it down and clean it. Everything wipes away a lot easier. So we got everything put on there. Let's wipe this off with something. We're out here at the old range because it's wide open. There's nothing out here for the sound to bounce back, so we get a better sound quality and a more accurate representation of what the sounds like. The other range I have as a hillside, it's all in the woods, so it's really loud in there. So I wanted to come out here. We're not gonna shoot at targets. We're gonna shoot at absolutely nothing, just to really get the sound of the suppressor itself. So we will shoot the first two shots. The first shot is going to be the loudest, but then after that, we should be good. So we'll shoot the first shot, and then right after, I will shoot a second shot. All right, so that is absolutely hearing safe. No issues. I'm not gonna put hearing protection at all on this entire time because the goal is to tell you guys if this is hearing safe or not. Very hearing safe, nice and quiet. So you could hear the bullet actually going through the tall grass over there, which is kind of cool because this isn't loud enough to completely eliminate hearing other things as well. I brought out a mic here because I wanted to get as good sound quality as possible. Again, unfortunately, it's just like flashlights when I do light reviews. You can't unfortunately always see the best or hear the best on video. So you guys are really gonna take my word on a lot of this stuff, but that's why I want to come out here and just kind of give you guys my thoughts after shooting it and kind of share what we think. We're one baffle down, so we'll see where we're at with this one. Whew. Okay, once again, suppressor is hearing safe. There's really not a lot else to say other than I can hear just fine and it's not hurting my ears. There's no ringing, but there wasn't a huge difference between this and the last one. So we'll go back, we'll do one more and keep the process going. This is where I'm really interested because this is where it gets a little more serious because the size is so much significantly smaller than a lot of the stuff on the market, which is cool. So opposed to having the other two baffles on here, this becomes a lot more manageable. So if this is hearing safe, then it makes more sense. Why wouldn't you want a smaller suppressor and it still being hearing safe? So this is something I could see myself running this size as long as it is really comfortable to the ear. So let's run two through it. If I could put the magazine in. Okay, so it's definitely a little louder. I definitely could tell a difference in the audible tone on that one, but again, still hearing safe. I had no issues, no ringing, no annoyances. I could definitely keep shooting. I'm gonna shoot here on steel if I can hit it. It's like 30 yards away. Let's see if I can hit here. Yeah, I mean, hitting the target is louder than the suppressor, which is super cool. But with this configuration and this size, still very hearing safe, and I would be comfortable shooting like this for a long period of time and not have to wear hearing protection. So we're one baffle down, and this one I'm really excited about because this is getting to the point where it is pretty tiny, especially if you're using this for like home defense or concealed carry where you're inside a residence and you shoot this. If you don't have a suppressor on, you're gonna mess your ears up, but if you at least have some kind of suppression enough to where it's not gonna blow your eardrums out, that is pretty cool. So I'm excited to see where this goes from here and how this one sounds. So we'll shoot this, and we got a couple more left to go after this, but let's see where this one's at because I think this one's gonna be more of a popular size for those that actually want to carry this because I mean, yeah, it sticks out a decent amount, but it's not too much farther than your Surefires, which I carry all the time anyway. And you're having the benefit of actually having a suppressor. As long as you have a good holster and you're comfortable with carrying with that extra length, I can see people wanting to use this or even for home defense a lot. So let's shoot these ones. Man, that is still fairly quiet. Again, it's obviously a little bit louder. I don't want to say that it caused ringing because there's no ringing in my ears at all, but you could definitely tell there was a different pitch to that one. So I don't know what you guys are hearing on the mic. That's why I did the mics and everything. I wanted this to be the best sound quality as possible. So I don't know what you guys are hearing, but hopefully you're able to hear that pitch really good. That was kind of the goal with this, but that one did have a different pitch. So let's go one less and see where that is. We're one more down and this is absolutely tiny. I mean, this is basically the size of the head of your flashlight or like a key fob. So really, really cool that you're able to have the modularity to bring this down to the size. And I mean, look at the size. That is crazy. So if this has the ability to not hurt your ears when shooting it, I'm gonna be wildly impressed and super happy with it. So far I've been very happy with this and the way it has sounded. We'll see, I'm gonna guess before we do this, that the decibel is definitely gonna be a little bit louder, and I think you're gonna hear a crack. I think you're gonna hear something. Like, I feel like this is gonna be slightly uncomfortable to shoot, but let's see. These are gonna be actually my first shots with the 147s out in an open area. So let's go ahead and shoot these. Let's talk. Wow. That's cool. Let me shoot again. That's cool. So that one had a really slight pop. Like, it wasn't at all annoying. Like, I could shoot more, which I'll shoot another one here. Like, it definitely has like a pop to it. But again, I'm not wearing hearing protection. My ears aren't ringing, which impresses me a lot and makes me super happy. So this one is still hearing safe. I think this is actually the smallest it goes. We'll try to take one off. I'm not sure if I can go any smaller than this. But very impressed with how that sounds, especially out here in the open. I was expecting more of a crack. Didn't get that. It was more of a pop on that one. Definitely a different decibel sound than the one previously, because the first two or three was very low, muffled. You didn't hear really anything. That middle one was more of like, you could hear the pitch changing, and this one was more of a pop, which I didn't get with the other ones. But still, again, absolutely hearing safe. Let's see if we can hit a target here. Yeah, so I would say that those were very similar in sound. Like the shot had a pop and the steel had a pop. So they both sounded similar in sound. So not where the last one, the target sounded louder, this one sounded pretty similar in sound. But again, I'm really impressed because if you run this concealed and have to use it, yes, it might not be the quietest thing or movie theater quiet, but what you're getting is the benefit of not having hearing problems or hearing loss, which is something that we don't want to deal with if you happen to use your firearm to defend yourself.
I hope that video was helpful to you to make a decision if this is a good suppressor for you, or maybe this is something you should pass on and maybe go with something different. That is always my goal, is to help you guys spend your money in the best way possible, because I know how hard it is to work, get your money, and you want to actually spend it on something you want instead of getting it and being like, well, this is junk. Like, I don't want this anymore. And you throw it into a bin and you never see it again. You just wasted your money. So hopefully this was able to help you in that. I just set this in a different configuration again, so just showing you guys the different lengths, different host, but it's just cool. I am a really big fan of these suppressors. The RCX has been cool. That's going to be living on the 6.5 Creedmoor build, and the 308 that is on that wall, which I need to give you guys a more updated video here. The whole room has kind of grown since I last showed you guys. So that'll be coming very soon. If you guys have any specific questions about this, please let me know. I'll gladly get you the information on that. If I don't know, I'll find somebody that does know the information and I'll get that to you as quickly as possible. As always, I thank you guys so much and I appreciate you. If you are looking to help out the channel and the things I do here, there's a couple ways to do that down in the description. There are some discount codes from companies that I personally trust that you can save some money. And there is a link to my link tree from there. There's some links like Premier Body Armor, Palmetto Star Armory, Brownells. Anything you purchase using those links does help out with the channel and does support me. So I appreciate it if you do that. If not, I just appreciate you guys liking, subscribing, sharing, commenting. Those things do help out a ton. I got a big influx of subscribers there about a month ago. It was like 26,000 new subscribers. So thank you to all the new subscribers. Thank you to all the people that have been here from the start or anywhere in between. I couldn't do any of this without you guys. So thank you so much for that. A couple of companies that support me and the things I do here, Howitzer Brownells and Hold Up Displays. Howitzer is a clothing brand that donates 5% of proceeds to charity. And they did a collaboration with me on my own t-shirts, which I love. So in the description, you can pick one up for yourself. Brownells is a company that you can use code TA10 and save 10% on orders of $150 or more. And you can pick up pretty much anything there. And that discount code can help you save a ton. So take advantage of that and use it as much as you want. Share it with all your friends. And you can save a ton of money doing that. And then Hold Up Display, they make these walls here. And I need to update you guys because things have changed a lot. And I'm really excited to see where this room grows. Other than that, guys, I appreciate you all and thank you so much.